On June 9th, 2018, in Vancouver, British Columbia, on a weekend trip to Canada, I went to this place called Vidges. I would be dining with my dad and my girlfriend Anna, and outside of my trip to New Delhi in 2017, this was my first meal of quote-unquote elevated Indian food, so I was really eager to eat a lot and be inspired. Vikram Vij, that's the guy that's walking around in the bar right here, opened Vidges in 1994, actually in a different space. This newer location is the flagship of the restaurant group and pitches traditional Indian methods and spices comboed with sustainable produce from British Columbia to create this spot. We decided to wait for our table in the bar. My dad went with a gin and tonic. Anna and I both wanted to try their gin cocktails as well, so one Lilu and one Last Hurrah. It wasn't crazy hot outside, but they were still really refreshing and set the tone for all the flavors we were about to see. Making our way into the restaurant, you get the choice of two menus. One is this huge a la carte menu. A lot of it is actually handwritten. The smaller one is a tasting menu where you get the choice between dishes for each course. Indian food is, of course, great to share, so to maximize the amount of dishes we would get to try and to save some money for some wine, we went and ordered off the a la carte menu. Speaking of wine, this is the Synchromesh Four Shadows Riesling, that's by the glass. A dish of spiced and braised rabbit with jalapeno and raw sugar. The meat was not dry, it was sweet and spicy, served with a little bit of naan to pinch it between and eat. A garam masala portobello mushroom in porcini cream. This was intensely aromatic, not just of mushrooms, but the spice balance was great. I would have ordered this again over any of the other meat dishes we had. More naan with rice this time. I can't help but think they make their naan intentionally smaller so they can give you fresh pieces throughout your meal. I thought that was a really nice touch. Moving on to red wine now, this is the Joey PTG. Super affordable but really delicious Pinot Noir from the Okanagan Valley. I never get a chance to drink Canadian wines, so I took this opportunity. Pork tenderloin now with a tangy cayenne and ginger sauce. Nothing mind-blowing here, but it was still really delicious. Their signature lamb lollipop marinated in wine with a fenugreek curry. This was really tasty. Definitely order this if you get a chance to come to Vidges. A paneer, ginger, cilantro, and garlic cake here with tomato curry. This one fell a little bit short for me. The paneer texture wasn't appealing and the curry wasn't as flavorful as some of the other ones we had on the table. Next up, a Punjabi-style goat curry with spiced vegetables. My dad uses the goat dishes as a measure of a good Indian restaurant and he was happy with this, so I can't complain. On to the sweets. Kulfi, a really aromatic rice pudding, and gulab jamuns because my dad's sweet tooth is just as bad as mine. Total for everything came out to $297.38. That is in Canadian dollars. Add a touch more on top of that for the tip. And overall, the variety of food and the drink we had, coupled with the knowledgeable and generally nice service, I would say this was an incredible value. Was it the best Indian food I've had? Outside of India, I would say yeah, it was really great to see a spot doing food that keeps one foot planted in tradition and really solid technique, and another one stepping into the more modern. Where should I go next? Let me know down low in the comments. My name is Justin Khanna. Have a good one.